She says if everyone drops their ego, there would be no civilization and everybody would be roaming naked in the jungle. We have to understand what is ego and what is civilization. What is it that is meant by civilization? Civilization refers to a particular order in living, a particular system in living, an orderliness. That is the meaning of civilization. Is it clear what is civilization? Civilization refers to an orderliness in living. An orderliness. That it is not random, it is orderly. That living is not random, it is orderly. Order can come from two sources. Order can arise from two distinct sources. Order can arise either out of fear, as you see in our society, that if people are civilized, then most of them behave in a civilized way because of fear of punishment. Right? Order can arise from there. And when there is fear, there is ego. Because you are afraid of somebody else. That's what ego is. Somebody else dominating your mind. So we have seen order only of one kind, civilization only of one kind, which is the civilization arising from fear. That if I behave in an uncivilized way, then I will be jailed or I'll lose my respectability. Hence Dipanshu. Hence Dipanshu is justified in thinking that the very basis of civilization is fear. No, Dipanshu. The civilization that we see, this is based on fear. But it is not necessary that civilization or order is necessarily, must necessarily be based on fear. Orderliness, civilization can come from another source. What source is that? That source is that of your intelligence. For example, we have this room and there are molecules, air molecules in this room. The molecules are not very tightly packed as well. We know the packing ratio. For every unit of volume that a molecule, occupies, there are many times of volume that is free space. Still, what are these molecules doing all the time? They are colliding with each other and there is no order. This is what you call as Brownian motion, random motion. Whereas, if this room is full of people and these people are given different tasks for which they have to move about, constantly move about. Say, a group of people has been told to whitewash that wall. A group is mopping this floor. Another group is taking care of the ceiling. So all three directions, X, Y, and Z. Still these people will not collide with each other the way molecules do. Because these people will function out of their intelligence. And out of intelligence, a certain order is born. If these same people are drunk, if they are under the influence of a liquor, then they will surely collide with each other because then intelligence will become dormant. Are you getting it? Order comes out of intelligence. But we have not seen that order. We have seen only one kind of order which comes from fear. So Dipanshu is justified in thinking that if ego goes away, order will also go away, civilization will go away. No. The fact of the matter is, what you today call as civilization is nothing but fear. It is not civilization at all. It is just a suppression of all that is beastly within us. That is the reason why whenever man gets a chance to beat the law, he does it. That is the why only 3% people pay income tax. Whosoever gets a chance to defy civilization, he does. That is why there are murders and loops and rapes. The moment there is absence of fear, there is chaos, there is disorder. Because the very basis of our civilization is fear. You take away fear, civilization collapses. Surely such a civilization is of very little value. Getting it? Fear comes from outside, it is ego. Intelligence is your own. There is a civilization that can come from your intrinsic intelligence.